is a presentation of the ACC Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports.
Well, game one is in the books. Game two is on the way. NC State and Boston College State, the favorite in that game. We've documented the fact they need to win to get an NCAA tournament bid. Stand up. That's the song by James Durbin helping us in this tournament. Who will stand up in game two? We welcome you back to Phillips Arena in Atlanta and ACC Network coverage of the Atlantic Coast Conference Tournament. This is the first round today, and we're getting ready for the number five seed, NC State, a team that had 20 wins on the season, taking on Boston College. And the Eagles, 9-21 on the year. They had four league wins. NC State was 9-7 in league play, but still got some work to do to make it to the NCAA tournament. Game one in the books. We've set up the quarterfinal matchup for tomorrow, North Carolina and Maryland. And I'm glad that Terrell Stoglin and Nick Faust got some rest because they're going to need their shooting legs tomorrow. Stoglin with 25 points.
And Stoglin did a great job getting his teammates involved early in the game before he started to take over, but had a very efficient shooting game, 8 for 14. And a lot of that had to do with the production by Nick Faust, who was a Batman to talk about Superman on his side.
Hey, you don't think that freshman likes being here in the ACC tournament? Look at that reaction. He had 18 points. We take a look again at our Toyota brackets, and you can see Maryland and North Carolina. Who will play Virginia? Will it be NC State or Boston College? We're about to find out. And you see the two teams, the teams playing tonight, Clemson, Virginia Tech. I agree with Tim Brandt that Virginia Tech's going to be tough out. Miami and Georgia Tech. Now here's NC State. You know, when you talk about the history of this tournament, you got to start with NC State and those great Everett Case teams. They won 10 championships overall. They won the very first ACC tournament in 1954. And who will forget 1983 in Atlanta when they had to win to get on, and they went on. That was the Jim Valvano team that went on to win the national championship. But NC State, I thought, been playing much better of late.
And talking with Coach Mark Godfrey yesterday, he's excited about the opportunity that they have here in order to be able to come in and get some wins, make a statement not only to the NCAA tournament committee, but that NC State basketball is back in the ACC.
Corey, they've beaten NC Boston College twice. It's always tough to beat a team three times. I don't care who they are.
It really is. And for Boston College, of course, these guys are learning every time out. It's new for them, and this is their first time through. And then being on this stage in the ACC tournament, I told you about my experiences as a freshman. Well, they have nine freshmen and, of course, a number of people who've only been here. This is their first time on this stage. So it's going to be interesting to see how they react.
One of the reasons that NC State's been playing better lately is that Scott Wood has finally found his shooting touch. He's broke out of a horrible slump, and that's been good things for the Wolfpack.
And a four-game skid, Scott Wood was only averaging 6 points a game for NC State. Since then, he's got his shooting touch back and averaging 17 over his last two. Been a key guy for NC State and the success that they've had at the end of the season.
We talked about Mark Godfrey yesterday, and he said, boy, you know, when he's playing well, our whole team just takes a deep breath and relaxes. And you look at the numbers from Scott Wood in NC State wins and losses, and you see exactly what we're talking about. It makes a huge difference when he's scoring.
It really does, because he stretches out the defense for the other guys like C.J. Leslie to operate inside, as well as Richard Howe.
And you see those numbers here. Look at ACC wins and losses. That is a huge difference, Corey.
It's a huge discrepancy, and just as well, he's the one that really is the leader of this team. He's a senior. The guys follow him, and he's the guy that leads by example, so they love to see Scott Wood be successful.
Now, you talked about all those young players for Boston College. They've got two that average in double figures in Ryan Anderson and Matt Humphrey. Anderson is also the leading rebounder. I think if they're to win today, he's got to be a key.
Will they really do it? Ryan Anderson has really stepped up his production. He was an all-ACC freshman team player, and he's really providing the cornerstone, of course, for Coach Donahue, he alongside Dennis Clifford, to build upon, especially in that front court.
Well, you know, they are capable of a surprise. We'll talk more about the matchup between the Eagles and the Wolfpack when we come back to Atlanta.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by BB&T, by your local Toyota dealers, by Food Lion, and by AT&T.
And we welcome you back to Atlanta, the number 5 seed NC State. They won the last two games of the regular season. Boston College last won on February 29th. They are the big underdogs, Corey. Let's get your 4 keys to this game.
Well, for Boston College, they have to grow up in a hurry. We talked about 9 freshmen, 12 newcomers. But at this point in the season, with 30 games under their belt, they have to grow up. They can't play like freshmen. For NC State, they have to seize the moment, understand that this is an opportunity for them to make an impression on the NCAA tournament committee. They probably need at least 2 wins here to be able to get in, and it starts today.
Well, we will see what happens in just a moment. Right now, it is time for us to send it back to the guys who will call game number 2, Tim Brandt, Mike Chiminski. Looking forward to a good game here between State and Boston College.
All right, Mike, thank you very much. We agree with you. It should be a good ball game. We hope so, but not like 8-9. I mean, this is 5-12. There's a difference. There's a separation between these two, Mike.
Yeah, and NC State, as Corey talked about, won both of these games, but they were able to control BC, able to control the tempo in the game on their home court. I think for North Carolina State, they want to play at a much faster pace, use their size and athleticism.
And you think that they have to win here today to get to the NCAA?
Oh, yeah, a loss would be devastating.
So it's the number 5 seed, the number 12 seed, Boston College and NC State coming up next. First-year head coach Mark Gottfried has led NC State to 20 wins already this season, but the Wolfpack have more goals in mind. At the top of the list, winning their first ACC title in 25 years. Second-team All-ACC forward C.J. Leslie and third-teamer Lorenzo Brown have high hopes as they begin tournament play. Boston College comes to Atlanta looking to make a little noise. The Eagles have 9 freshmen on the roster, led by Ryan Anderson. The Eagles already have 1 upset this season over 15th-ranked Florida State. The starting lineups and the tip-off coming up next. It is a gorgeous day in Atlanta. As you look outside Phillips Arena, fans now coming inside, getting ready for the second game of this 59th annual Atlanta Coast Conference Tournament. Take a look at the starting lineups first for Boston College. This is a team that starts 4 freshmen and Matt Humphrey, who is a transfer. They don't have anybody that averages double figures other than Ryan Anderson in that starting lineup. So they are young, they are learning, they are continuing to mature. Meanwhile, for NC State, they come in with a record of 20-11, and all 5 starters are in double figures. Lorenzo Brown, C.J. Williams, Wood, Deadly from outside, C.J. Leslie and Howe combined for 24 a game. Right now, let's go over to Debbie Antonelli. Debbie.
Well, Mark Gottfried, the head basketball coach at NC State, spent a lot of time in his past with head coach John Wooden, who recently passed away. One of the things that Coach Gottfried learned from Coach Wooden is teach what you know and know what you teach. He understands how to have offensive balance. As you mentioned, Tim, all 5 players in double figures. Nobody takes more than 11 shots. Nobody takes less than 8 in his system. 61% of his baskets are assisted, which means they share the basketball very well. And 40% of their missed field goal attempts are rebounded on the offensive end, which means they understand where their good shots are coming from and when to get to the glass. It's pretty good offensive balance for 5 starters to be in double figures.
Well, Debbie, you know, you look at it, and I think clearly that Mark Gottfried brought structure. This is basically the same team that was there last year, and they bought into his offensive philosophy. And I really think, too, that Lorenzo Brown has been such a huge key. I mean, from day one, Mark Gottfried said, you're my point guard, and he has had a terrific season.
The officials, Les Jones, Brian Dorsey, Sean Hull. A very good officiating team here this afternoon for the second game. Maryland won the opener against Wake Forest, and they won it big. We'll see what happens here. NC State and Boston College. Wolfpack have it first.
This is Williams. And they turn it over. Turnover number one for NC State.
Normally, the Lorenzo Brown is very sure with the basketball. It's an excellent assist-to-turnover ratio. The big key for NC State is going to be Scott Wood. He seems to have rediscovered his shooting stroke, and they need him to hit some bombs to open this offense up.
Daniels resets. Shot clock at 15. Gets a screen from Clifford with the pick and roll, and they turn it over. Still looking for the first shot. It comes from Brown, and the putback by Howell.
I think that's where the big advantage is for NC State up front on the glass. Howell, one of the premier rebounders in the conference, third, just under 10 a game. And Lorenzo Brown is at his best when he's in the open floor.
Boston College having a tough time finding a shot. This is Anderson. His shot is short. Last touch by Boston College, so NC State will have the ball. Make a good point as you look at Mark Gottfried in his first year. Coached at Alabama from 1999 to January 2009. Was an ESPN analyst. Came back to replace Sidney Lowe. But, I mean, this is a club that was 10th last year. They come in here as the number four seed. Mostly the same talent.
Well, I think of the new coaches. Yeah, he had, that's the key word, he had the most talent to work with coming back. But that's still, you have to you coach them up. And like I said, they've responded to the structure both on and off the floor.
This is Humphrey, tries the pick and roll, throws it away. Turnover number two.
He's the guy who's got to play well today. He's their most experienced player by far, and he's got to have a terrific game. And I also believe that Boston College has got to hit a ton of threes in this game.
They've got to get a shot off first, any kind of shot. Two turnovers already to start the game. Little skip pass into Howell, blocked from behind. He follows his shot and taken away by Ryan Anderson.
I really like the maturation of Dennis Clifford. He's given them a nice option in the low post. Really works hard at his game. Incredible shot blocker.
Just a freshman, but he did have that extra year at Milton Academy. This is for three. State will push it. If it's not there, though, they aren't in a hurry. Back outside to Williams.
Not a full double team, kind of a half dig by Boston College. Letting Clifford play by himself.
Shot clock down to 10. Brown right to the hoop. It's knocked out of bounds. It'll belong to NC State with six on the shot clock. NC State loves to spot Wood after the three-pointer. They'll drive and kick it back out to it. Here he is with five on the shot clock. And knocks it down. He is a terrific shooter. That is for two. His first bucket of the game.
Yeah, and so, you know, Lonnie Jackson did a nice job taking away the three. You want to make him a driver, make him a two-point shooter instead of an open three-point shooter.
Back outside, Anderson looked at it. Shot clock down to 11. Shot clock at 7. And that was just a brick thrown up by Lonnie Jackson. Not even close.
And then he's their most reliable perimeter shooter, too.
Back outside to Williams. Steps in, gives it to Leslie. Howell gets it back.
Not a good shot by Leslie, but he gets bailed out on the rebound.
Scramble, and Howell comes away with it. No, taken away by Humphrey and the foul. Good hustle by Boston College to scramble after the loose rebound. 15-51 to play in the first half. A 2-4-point lead as you look at the varsity at lunch. There's Jim Hunt, the former governor of North Carolina, served four terms, having a little popcorn, chilling, relaxing, retired. What better way to do that than here at the Atlantic Coast Conference Tournament? Mike, what are the keys to success for Boston College?
This is what Steve Donahue believes in. They're going to have to make 10 three-pointers in this game, and I think that's right on it. And take care of the basketball. They've already got 2 turnovers. They want 10 or less for the game, and then keep opponents to 10 or fewer offensive rebounds. And that, again, a strength. You would think that would be an asset for North Carolina State in this game.
Not the most riveting first 5 minutes of the game, only 4 points scored, but I would think that is good for Boston College. Back in, turn around, Anderson can't score.
Well, they want this game to play out like it did up in Chestnut Hill, where they kept it in the 50s, and it's trending that way right now.
Anderson with a rebound after the Wood miss. Boston College lost to Miami 77-56 in the regular season finale. Humphrey led the Eagles with 16 points. Still have no points on the board here.
Boston College only sending one player to the offensive glass, so they're taking a chance on the shot. There won't be many second chance opportunities.
Wood, splash.
Yeah, this has been a little bit different player. 8 threes in the last 2 games, and that is very good news for Wolfpack fans.
41% from the bonus sphere. He's the guy that shoots them. He's the guy normally who hits them for State.
And in the second half of the season, Tim, he had gotten so much defensive attention. The team's just really blanketing him, not letting him getting shot opportunities at all.
Humphrey misses his shot. Still no points. Ahead to Williams. Nice look underneath to Leslie, who finishes strong.
It's just so effortless inside. And one of the first guys to come out of high school and go straight into the pro ranks is Bill Willoughby. He just had such an effortless, easy rise to his game. And that's what C.J. Leslie reminds me of.
Boston College on the ropes early. And he traveled. Another turnover. Has there ever been a shutout?
There's the look inside. Good movement. He just kind of got lost along the backside of the defense. Everybody getting their head turned. Ryan Anderson saw where it was, but nobody else did.
Boston College substitutions.
So Boston College makes some changes. John Cowell comes into the ballgame, a graduate student, joined the team as a walk-on originally. That was last season. Having the time of his life now.
Well, and it's in two. Whenever Steve Downey wants to calm things down, he gets Gabe Moten into the... out under the floor. He started earlier this year, was really one of the more seasoned players that they had.
Wood, bang. 8 points for Wood early. Right now, Steve Donahue looking for anything that can generate offense. The alley-oop. Timeout, Boston College.
Timeout, Boston College.
What a start for the Wolfpack.
Right now, C.J. Leslie doing it on both ends of the floor. Defensively with the quick hands, Anderson kind of losing track of where things were. And then he hustling it down, and then usually the guy who finishes this play is the one who started it, but Lorenzo Brown getting out, showing some up.
Steve Donahue is completing his second year at Boston College. He looks at that, immediately called the timeout. He had 10 years at Cornell, now rebuilding at the Heights. But he is an outstanding coach. He's won 3 Ivy League titles, 2008, 9, 10, trip to the Sweet 16. But this is a chore. He's got young kids, 9 freshmen in the transfer.
Wow, and he knew he was going to have some attrition last year. He didn't think he was going to lose 10 Letterman. And that's just, in this league, that's tough to absorb.
You're the fans up in Chestnut Hill. Patience is the word, but believe me, he will win. Kick out. Cow back out front. Moat penetrates and has it blocked. Shot clock at 10. Humphrey on the baseline and turns it over. And Wood is fouled by Ryan Anderson.
Just right now, he's just in full search mode, and they just need to see the ball go through the basket one time to feel like they're part of it. There's the roster break.
Look at that. Mike, have you ever seen that before in the Atlantic Coast Conference?
No, and I think only this year the military academies are that young, and nobody else in a power conference comes even close.
So Casey Cottle comes into the game as Clifford goes out. Moten takes it away, gets it ahead to Humphrey. Takes it right at the rack, and Boston College is on the board.
Yeah, and they did a nice job forcing it to his right hand. He's a left-handed player, but at least something positive.
Howell takes it right back at the rack. 16-2, NC State. This is for three. Yes. Nicely done by Ryan Anderson. Coming into this tournament, Anderson has averaged 15 points, 9 rebounds over the final 7 regular season games.
Well, this is the end they have to build on now. You know, you've gotten a little bit of confidence, but for BC, you've got to get some stops.
Step back jumper too long. Moten with the drive, but he's got called for the push-off. Offensive foul. 11:42 to play. 16-5 State. What are you having?
Well, we talked about it. Scott Woods swooned a little bit in the last half of the ACC season, but has come out of that 8 threes in his prior 2 games and really shooting with a lot of confidence right now. To 3 of 4 in this game for 8 points.
Mike, you mentioned his last 2 games, 8 threes, and he's one of those guys that when he starts finding the range from long distance, look out. Against Virginia Tech Sunday, hit 3 threes, 19 points. Had 16 points the first time they played Boston College. Sean Painter comes into the ballgame now, so they go from big to big. This is the first time State and Boston College have ever met in the ACC tournament. Wood looked at the three. They continue to move it around. Back out to Painter. Good hustle by State, but they lose it out of bounds. It'll belong to the Eagles.
Well, he's the guy. When Painter's in the game, they're going to come hot off of him and double team down in the low post. If Leslie is down there, Painter's got to follow him down or make them pay for that double team.
Don't forget, coming up tonight, Virginia Tech, Clemson, and then Georgia Tech against a very dangerous Miami team. Tim Brando and Dan Bonner will step in and take over. It's the ACC tournament in its first full day. Another turnover for the Eagles. That's 7 already. And Steve Donahue is a little bit frustrated. Last year he led the Eagles to 21-13 record on berth in the NIT, advanced to the second round. But as Mike said, they lost so many guys, and now they're so young.
That's not a great sign when you have more turnovers than points in a game.
That's not good.
That's not good now. Talked about it. You're a lot of firsts for a freshman in your first ACC tournament game. It's a different deal.
NC State, on the other hand, is trying to make a statement. They want to get into the NCAA tournament. Williams shot throws iron.
And like Maryland in the first game, want to try to expend as little energy in doing it as well to save the legs.
Well, they had the adrenaline flow early in the first couple of minutes and just exploded. Now the game seems to be settling into a little bit of a rhythm. Heckman has it knocked out of bounds by Wood.
Very underrated defensive player, and right from his freshman year, too. And everybody knows about his, you know, the shooting stroke and the threes and everything, but he's always been solid on this end of the floor.
Big old Casey Cottle comes in for Dennis Clifford. Clifford gets another rest. DC Cottle, 6'10", 280 pounds, a freshman out of California, Rio Linda High School. Moten picked up his dribble, got into trouble, finally found some help. Now they go down to Cottle, and his little jumper is knocked away. He's fouled, he wants goaltending. Sean Hall says, settle down.
0, Jackson, 10.
Yeah, that just shows you the rise of CJ Leslie.
Foul is on Deshaun Painter. That is his first. So Cottle goes to the line. Parade High School All-American, second teamer. A 60% free throw shooter. And misses the first. Closed captioning for ACC basketball provided by Bojangles' famous chicken and biscuits. It's bow time. He's made 14 of his 23 this year and makes the second.
Boston College substitution.
So it's a 10-point game.
Number 22, John.
I haven't seen this lineup much for BC going big with both Clifford and Caudill out on the floor at the same time.
And for Wolfpack, number one, Richard Howell.
Counter, you got Howell and Painter out there. You really get four centers on the floor at one time.
John Cal stays out there as well. Cottle on Painter. Back out front to Wood. Johnson swings it around. Johnson's been a pleasant addition. Brown shot is off. Painter gets it back and takes it right strong to the hoop.
Well, what you're trying to do if you're BC to put your big lineup out there is to eliminate offensive rebounds, but NC State's still getting on the glass.
12-point lead for the Pack. And Moten is called for a foul. So they turn it over, then foul, and here's what you were talking about, Mike.
Yeah, and this is where Painter usually gets his offense off the missed shot. Staying on it, give Howell a little credit for keeping it alive.
Alex Johnson running the point now for NC State. He provided a much-needed option at point guard, which State didn't have last year.
And also, it allows Lorenzo Brown to play off the ball. He'll play some at two and lets him be a scorer. He's got a smaller guard on him, maybe some post-up opportunities there.
Howell with a jumper.
We talk about responding to the system, and I think that C.J. Williams and Richard Howell are two of the more improved players in the league this year as a result of working within that offense.
Howell's got 6 points. He only averages 10. Shot hits the rim, goes out of bounds. Been a tough first half for the Eagles. ACC has announced its 2012 Legends class to be honored in Atlanta this Saturday with the annual Legends Brunch. Great names include Boston College's John Bagley and Todd Fuller from NC State. For more information on all the ACC Legends and how to meet them on Saturday, just log on to theacc.com. It really is a great brunch. It's fun. You get up close and personal with these guys. You get to talk to them, meet them.
Yeah, I was honored to be a part of that one year. It is. The commissioner's done a great job of implementing that and bring the history of the league back for this event.
And Wood is fouled from beyond the arc. Foul is on Lonnie Jackson, and so Wood will go to the free throw line, and he is a terrific free throw shooter.
Yeah, I mean, this is, for a freshman, it's the learning process. You're not going to block that shot, and you don't want to put the best free throw shooter in the conference on the line.
92% from the line. Let's go over to Debbie.
Guys, you alluded to the shooting slump that Scott Wood was in prior to the last two games. He was 6-for-27 outside the arc in the last five. Of course, he's made 8 in the last two, counting what he's done here tonight. And then I asked Scott, why was he in such a slump? He said, as a shooter, you just have to work through it. You have to keep taking shots. Coach Godfrey gave him a lot of confidence, and he said he went to shooter's therapy, which meant, in his mind, was just to make sure you kept taking shots so that you could clear your mind and continue working on your stroke. He knows he's a good shooter. He just needed to get back in rhythm.
Well, it sure worked. He's 3-for-4 here today and perfect at the free throw line.
Well, I think too, when watching his game, that he went for a stretch where he was getting better looks in transition from behind the arc and had struggling a little bit from the half court.
This is going to be a 4-point play, possibly. Patrick Heckman hits the three, and he's fouled.
Yeah, again, another thing, you just want to close out, and normally C.J. Williams does that, but the cardinal sin that time of fouling the shooter, and you don't want to give Yeah, the four-point play might almost double BC's output up to this point.
And Williams still lobbying his case. It was sold well by Patrick Hickman. He went down. Patrick Hickman, a 6'5 freshman from Mainz, Germany. Mom was a competitive gymnast, his dad a basketball player. Well, and he has the four-point play.
And Tim, I'm going to say this. You know what? You've got 10 points you scored in the first 12 minutes of the game, and you're only down 13. You've got to feel like you dodged something. NC State has missed an opportunity to really separate in this game.
So Jackson pushes it up, and he loses it out of bounds. Steve Donahue still being the cheerleader over there, still being positive and optimistic with his guys and working his bench in and out.
Well, I did games with them in December when it was very much a work in progress, but the one thing he was very enthusiastic about working with this group. And, it's been a challenge for him, but he has loved coaching him the whole year.
Well, he's going to have him for a while, so that's a good thing. Air ball thrown up by Daniels. Inside to go to Howe. Great pass. Williams couldn't finish, and here come the Eagles. Boy, Ryan Anderson is really struggling with his shot early on.
He had that 1-3 early that he knocked down, but then that was a pretty decent look.
1-for-4 for Ryan Anderson. Painter with a little spin move, and he's fouled. He'll go to the line. Well, NC State came out with a lot of fire. They knew they had the advantage. Mark Gottfried knew they had to impress to get into the NCAA tournament. So far, it's been NC State big.
Let's take a look at the AT&T fast analysis and its offensive rebounding. For NC State, we thought this might be a area where they would have an advantage, and so far in this game, they've out-rebounded BC by 3, but 4 offensive rebounds, so they're getting about a third of their misses and converting on half of them.
Mark Gottfried taking a seat. He comes out of that seat, though, quickly when there's a turnover. That time, he didn't wait. So Painter at the line, he's got 2 points.
The one gap that NC State, they've played basically 7 guys, and the one gap they have in their rotation off the bench is a 6'7", 6'8 wing guy, which really would have helped the effort. You've got Johnson at the point and Painter up front, but they don't have that middle guy. So if the two CJs get in foul trouble or Wood, it really affects their rotation. So far, they've been able to avoid that in this game, and that's going to be a key for the tournament. You talk about the team that needs easy wins and the rest the most, it's got to be the Wolfpack.
Yeah, no question about that. Painter makes them both, and it's a 15-point lead. Painter goes out, CJ Leslie comes back in for NC State. And the Eagles continue to work hard and try to generate some points somehow. Still having a problem offensively.
Heckman right there just missed the easy putback for the offensive rebound.
I will say this about Heckman, though. He's given some life. Came back in, had that 4-point play, and here they are out running and get the bucket on the transition. Matt Humphrey, he has 4 points.
A good look ahead that time by Jordan Daniels. He dug in. Nice defensive play. They need more of those, getting stops and scoring off their defense.
NC State comes in with a record of 20-11. They're 9-7 in the Atlantic Coast Conference this year.
Let's see how they recognize this. BC in a zone right now.
And they call a foul down low. Big guys were bumping.
This is what happens when you're big and you put it on the ground. It brings the guards into play. And that was good quick hands and the good look ahead. We need more easy points like that.
Called the foul on Matt Humphrey. That's his first. Guys were bumping and grinding down there, and he got a little over anxious. Humphrey sat out last year after transferring from Oregon. Here's Johnson from way outside. And a nice play by Jackson to take it away.
It says BC is getting a little bit of confidence back in their game.
Well, that 3 by Humphrey was halfway down and came back out. He's a little bit frustrated right now.
Well, he really has not had great shooting numbers the whole year. 36% from the floor, 32 from three.
Hey, ACC fans, a reminder, if you want to win a Myrtle Beach golf vacation every month for a year, for you and a friend, all you have to do, go to PGA Tour Dustin Johnson and say, hey, you want to play around? Just text golf 88222 or go to golfholiday.com for your chance to win. You can win that golf holiday vacation.
Number five.
Yeah, I'd catch up to his drive with a drive and a three wood, I think.
I'm not sure if I could even then.
Shooting one and one.
Leslie at the line shooting one and one. And misses the front end. Boston College has to start taking advantage over these. Stops, come back, get a couple points. Little give and go there was nice. That'll be goaltending. That'll count. So Ryan Anderson has a bucket. He now has 5 points.
Yeah, here's a good look. Just a little two-man game at the top, and you know that Leslie's going to be lurking back there. But when it's right in the front of the rim like that, normally you'll get the goaltending call.
Cuts the lead back to 11. This is Wood for three. Yes.
Yeah, that's the Scott Wood that was around early in the year. And that was a pump fake and step up three, which gives you an idea of how far it was behind the arc.
14 points for Wood. Nice play into Clifford.
They're having some success with that screen and roll action in the middle of the floor. Second back Clifford now got a nice easy look that time.
I agree with you, Mike. They look like they're gaining some confidence as they go along here. But NC State is not backing off. Leslie now has 8. Or Hal, correction. Daniel's shot hits hard, comes back out. Brown with an off-balance shot, and he buries it.
You look at it, Jordan Daniel's 5'8", and Lorenzo Brown's 6'5". So there's a huge advantage there, and he took advantage of it by getting into the paint area. He doesn't even see Jordan Daniels when he elevates.
And Anderson finishes. And Heckman will tell you all the while that was a pass.
Yeah, and it was a good find inside, and I think he might have gotten away with a little bunny hop that time in travel, but any points, good points for BC at this point.
BC was just about ready to bring it down to the single digits, the lead by NC State, but then State exploded. Another foul, and with 3:59 to play in the first half, it's 32-18. NC State, as they continue to pound the boards and find the easy buckets inside. Watching the ACC Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports, where we encourage you to fan vote for your voice of the ACC first team, still open through Saturday. Chris Corciani, one of the all-time great NC Staters out there, having some fun with the young fans.
Found two people who was taller than. That's why he wanted to be in the picture.
Oh, that's funny.
He looked there like, I could post you guys up.
NC State leading big here, 32-18 in the first half. Now this is the free throw.
Second straight one and one that they've missed. So if you're Mark Godfrey, you don't want your team getting bored at this point of the game.
Heckman lifted the three, decided not to, and then turned it over. Here's Brown. Nice entry pass. Back outside to Brown. Kick it out for the three ball. And this will be on Howell over the back.
Fight that time, good block out. Sometimes, as you know, when you're an offensive rebounder, you want to think every missed shot is yours, but sometimes you just have to understand when you're not going to get it, and those are the type of cheap fouls that Richard Howell can pick up and get himself in trouble with.
This is from way outside. Yes. Nicely done by Lonnie Jackson.
He's 40% from three, and he's their best guy from there. So for him to regain some confidence is going to be huge.
Keep in mind, Boston College went scoreless over the first 7.5 minutes. NC State led 14-0. Lead now has been cut to 9. Williams has his shot blocked. Three. Now they'll try to cut it to 9.
Yeah, just shooting the ball a little bit better helps things. It gives you a little bit more confidence. They're starting to pick it up on the defensive end of the floor. Obviously, if you're Steve Donahue, you want that to be turned the other way around. But for a young team, a lot of time that happens. If they don't see the ball going through the hoop, their defensive effort isn't as good. But they've been much better on both ends of the floor in the last 10
Boston
minutes.
Boston College had good idea, poor execution there on the back door. Anderson couldn't handle the pass. They get a break and get it back as you look at.
You're right. I mean, you made a good point about Heckman coming in and giving them a little bit of a lift. He's got a nice bounce to his game.
He now goes out. Under 2.5 to play. This foul is on Scott Wood. That's his first or his second correction. So Wood will go out and Williams comes back in for NC State. Good look underneath, taken away. Johnson will push it. He's got numbers. Back to Johnson. And how about that follow? No bucket. No bucket. Howell picks up the foul over the back.
And it might have been with his left hand that got him in trouble. A nice soft shot. Yeah, he grabbed the arm with his left hand of Ryan Anderson. That's a good call by the officials.
Helped him elevate.
Sean Howell all over it.
Wow, did he go up with authority? What another opportunity by Boston College to get it to single digits. Jackson for three.
Different player. Get that shot go down. I mean, you know, Steve Donahue has got to be shaking it. He's got to be shaking his head inside going, I can't believe that we're still here at the half.
Got to give them a lot of credit, Mike. They continue to fight. They went 7-23 without a bucket.
Yeah, there's the play. And NC State getting a little lethargic defensively.
With 1:48 to play in the first. Take a look at our Haviland defensive shield.
Yeah, it's NC State in the late 60s, due to 10 points. I hope 12 to 10 was the final, and I hope whoever was betting it took the under. That would have been safe.
No shot clock, no three. Four corners. Boston College started this game 0 for 7. Since then, they're 9 of 16, including 4 threes, which you said would be their key.
Yeah, that 12-10, that must have kept the fans riveted.
Johnson with the alley-oop and another stop by Boston College.
You know what? When your things aren't exactly clicking right now for NC State, you can't take those chances. Heckman should have come down with that ball and regained his balance.
Here's Williams. I will say this, Steve Donahue is over there coaching these young guys.
It's funny, this BC group looks shell-shocked in the first 8 minutes, but their body language is pretty positive right now.
There's Lonnie Jackson, who just hit that three. Sees 9 on the shot clock. looks for a pick, the give and go.
Offensive?
Yes.
See, you can't for a big, too many dribbles that time for Clifford. Maybe he got the ball delivered a little early to him, but they've had some good success with that pick and roll action.
Dennis Clifford, that's his second.
Right. 19. That dribble right there, if you're gonna pull up and shoot the shot.
He didn't have all those gray hairs when the season started. Here's Brown, just to the right, shoots. All the way outside to Johnson. This is for three.
Not as many second chance points for NC State. They've gotten some offensive rebounds, but they haven't hurt BC there.
Final 30 seconds coming up at halftime. Analysis, highlights, stats, and a whole lot more all coming up on the Hardys halftime report. The turnover, the foul, and the bucket.
Steve Donahue is about to hang himself over on the sidelines. One, you get the last possession, and, you know, Jordan Daniels just lost concentration there. It was a terrific defensive play by Brown. And then you just compound things right there, giving him the three-point play opportunity.
They had it down to single digits. Now it's at 10. Brown will try to make it 11. Still have 15 seconds left. Seven seconds left for Daniels. Daniels throws it away again. This is good if it goes. Yes, sir! Williams with the three to end the first half.
You give away 5 points in the last 20 seconds. You've worked hard to get it down to eight, and that's got to be really deflating. As Steve Donahue is going to have to coach these guys back mentally at half.
Looked at the clock and let it fly.
Yeah, that's good clock awareness. He was thinking about giving up the layup to Painter, but he knew he had to get something up on the rim.
What a first half by NC State. They jumped out to a 14-0 lead, and they lead it here at the half, 37-24. Mike Hogwood, Corey Alexander, when we come back to Atlanta.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by Gatorade, by your local Toyota dealers, and by Havila.
Hardys presents the Hardys Halftime Report. Our Southwest patty meld with jalapenos. It's a spicy twist on a classic burger, only at Hardys. 37-24, Boston College got it down to single digits. They couldn't hold it there, a late run by NC State. Scott Wood, we talked about at the beginning. I thought he shot the ball well early. One of the reasons they jumped out to a 14-0 lead.
Well, Scott Wood came out, and he got his jumper stuck on automatic, yeah. No question about it. And he was able to knock down big threes, spreading out Boston College's defense. But it was Richard Howell who really took over on the interior.
Yeah, inside, I thought Richard Howell was a real difference maker with 8 points.
He was, and offensive rebounding is one of his specialties. But at the same time, he plays with such a physical presence. And when you're playing against a young team like Boston College, it's hard for those guys to match up with the type of energy and effort Richard Powell was going to bring it inside.
Yeah, BC really had nobody who could match up with him inside.
They really didn't. And, of course, you know, there's a big difference in the strength of a senior compared to a freshman. And Richard Howell, even among seniors, is a grown man, to say the least.
But give BC some credit. They're down 14-0. They didn't score for 7 minutes, 23 seconds. I thought they did a good job of getting their composure back and getting in this game.
Well, to start the game, you know, Boston College looked like a deer in headlights. They were frozen. They were basically overwhelmed by the moment of playing in the ACC tournament. But from that point on, they were really able to step up and make a game of this. But a crucial last 30 seconds for Jordan Daniels, really giving a 5-point swing back in the favor of NC State.
All right, halftime at the ACC tournament. These guys on the trampoline. You know, Corey, I think you could do that as well. We have to see Corey with some acrobatics. Well, it is the trophy that they are battling for here today. NC State leading by 13 here at the break. Raycom Sports and the ACC have unlocked their archives with over 150 basketball games, and all can be seen for free at theacc.com. In 1987, North Carolina was the number two team in the nation, but ran into NC State in the ACC tournament finals. The Wolfpack leading by one in the final seconds, and the Tar Heels looked for the game winner, but it was no good. The Pack win 68-67. Relive and share your favorite ACC moments at theacc.com/vault. And in the 80s, there was some real magic for Jim Valvano's Wolfpack.
It really was. And when you look at the 80s Wolfpack, that was North Carolina's rival. That was the NC State Wolfpack program that Mark Godfrey is trying to get them back to in present day. But when you want to talk about true basketball programs, NC State really was at the top of the world during the 80s when Coach Valvano was there.
If you missed our first game, Maryland won over Wake Forest 82-60. May have been the best game Maryland played all year. Terrell Stokeland, leading scorer in the ACC with 25 points.
And just as you say, may have been the best game Maryland played all year, probably the best game Terrell Stokeland played all year. Only 14 shot attempts, 4 assists, 7 rebounds. And when you talk about playing a complete game and very efficient, that's what Maryland needs from him.
All right, there's our Nissan scoreboard and Big East final. Syracuse really has a battle with UConn, winning 58-55. Other games, number 12 Baylor is a winner over K-State, and Iowa and Illinois, that is now a final. Iowa has won that game. Indiana in the second half, leading Penn State big, and number 11 Georgetown leading in their game. C.J. Williams hit a shot at the end of the half. Here's how it sounded on the Wolfpack Radio Network with Gary Hahn.
Get to Anderson, loose ball all the way in midcourt, picked up by Williams. Jump shot from 30 feet at the horn, got it. It counts. And the Pack will take a 37-24 lead in the locker room.
James Durbin of American Idol fame, and so far NC State has been able to stand up here, at least in the first half, over Boston College, leading by 13. Mike Hogwood, Corey Alexander with you. Corey, we talked about Scott Wood. He had 3 threes in that first half. And as we said, this is what got NC State going.
And Scott Wood got it started, coming off, knocking down jumpers, probably the best, one of the best shooters in the country, definitely in the ACC. But Richard Howell getting going on the block, and his energy and aggressiveness on the block was really able to get NC State going. For Boston College, they were able to knock down 2 threes behind Lonnie Jackson, really getting them back into the game in the first half after a huge run by NC State to start it off.
Yeah, Jackson's shots from outside were absolutely huge. Here are the first half stats. NC State really cooled off in that last 10 minutes.
It really, NC State got off to such a hot start. They had to cool off, but a lot of it had to do with the fact that Boston College started to put a little pressure on their defense.
The ACC Digital Network gives fans access anytime, anywhere. The ACC Men's Basketball Tournament is underway, and we invite you to join host Kyle Montgomery and former Georgia Tech star Drew Barry as they break down every first-round game. Visit theacccdn.com for all your highlights and in-depth analysis. Second half is on the way. That means the G-Man and Tim Brandt on the other side.
ACC Basketball is brought to you by Hyundai, by GEICO, by Hardee's, and by your Carolina Ford dealers.
Welcome back inside Phillips Arena. Tim Brandt, Mike Jaminski with you as we're ready to start the second half. NC State gets out to a 14-0 lead. Boston College works, has the ball, down 8. Turn it over twice, 3 balls, see you, they're down 13.
And all in 20 seconds, too, so it's got to be disheartening for Steve Donahue. But
unbelievable.
They need to take much better care of the basketball in the second half.
But it is ironic that they're still in this. They're only down 13 here as we start the second half.
Yep, no, very, very fortunate.
Let's go over to Debbie.
Well, you're absolutely right, Mike. think that's exactly what Coach said from Boston College, is that they've got to take better care of the basketball. 13 turnovers on 8 steals. Those are live ball turnovers. They just simply can't play the pace that they want to play. If they can take better care of the basketball and get out and challenge shots, especially Scott Wood. And then for NC State, Mark Godfrey talked about adjustments in a ball screening action in the middle of the floor, and he thought after the first 7 minutes of the game, his team got too comfortable and a little bit too complacent. Look for them to try to do a better job of defending the ball screening action in the middle.
All right, Debbie, thanks. We talked about the balanced scoring of NC State. They have all 5 starters in double figures, and they had 6 guys in the box score after that first half. So Mark Godfrey's got to be pretty pleased, other than few of the turnovers late, a couple of the fouls that were committed in that first half. But I mean, it was, especially for Scott Wood, it was a very well played first half.
And if you're a guy, if you're a State fan, and for Mark Godfrey, you get on a guy who's in this tournament confident, you want it to be Scott Wood. That's a huge lift for them. And to follow up on the 13 turnovers, it's a collaborative effort. They've got 5 guys who have 2 or more turns, so it's not just one person.
Ball by Humphrey draws iron, and they come right back with it to set the offense up. Now, like Maryland in the first game, Maryland won easily. NC State will not be in a hurry. They'll just try to be efficient, not in a hurry. Melt the clock, shorten the game, get out of here, save the legs. Daniels with a nice dish. Ryan Anderson finishes it.
I think he's got a chance to be a very, very good ACC player. Ryan Anderson had a terrific freshman year. He's a tough cover at 6'8". He gets 7 rebounds out of him, 2 rebounds his position well.
Wood, Hal. Hal with the follow. Hal again. Ryan Anderson caught an elbow in the chops.
I'll tell you what, I mean, that's what they're going to do. They're going to go out and cover Wood, make him give up the ball. They'll play two-point basketball with Howell inside.
I agree with you with Ryan Anderson. He was the Gatorade Player of the Year in California down at Long Beach Poly. Everybody talks about the potential that he has, and he's just starting to realize how good he can be. 6'8", 217. Moves like a guard.
Trying to get Lorenzo Brown into the low block.
Here's Williams. Nice dish. Howell goes up and has it blocked.
Why put the ball on the floor right there? Just go right up with it.
Williams finishes.
Yeah, really good ball movement. Flash from the weak side inside by C.J. Williams.
41-26 NC State. Clifford scores.
Got in a two-man game, but he was able to work himself into the low block and got an angle to the rim on Howell.
Scott Wood. And out of bounds. Look at the matchups tonight, Mike. What do you think?
Well, Virginia Tech and Clemson just played recently down in Little John. It was a senior night down there. It was a very, very close game. Virginia Tech playing a lot better. And then, of course, Georgia Tech, a critical game, much like this one is for NC State, a critical game for Miami. And the fortunes of their season have depended on the health of Reggie Johnson.
Kick it out. This is for 3. Humphrey. And Howell with another rebound. Nice look to Leslie.
He's been much more aggressive looking for his own offense. Had a nice dribble drive a couple of possessions ago. And then really runs rim to rim extremely well.
So Brown was looking at him the entire trip down the court. And then found him when he freed. Humphrey takes it right at the rack and scores.
I like that decision. Rather than settle for the jump shot, he tried to be aggressive and go inside.
.16:45 to play in the second game of the ACC tournament. Anderson gets it out to Humphrey. Jackson reset with 20 on the shot clock. Nice little give and go there. Made it tougher than it had to be.
Well, that's a pretty nice play by Connell, too, keeping the ball just possession high and letting his man work off of him.
Brown takes it at the rack. Howell has it knocked out of bounds. Just too much NC State right now. They're too big, too long, too strong. Here's a nice play, though, Mike.
Yeah, that's a good cut. And again, Jackson's a guy that NC State would be better served to make him a driver rather than letting him get looks from three.
Here's Brown. Believe this is the first time these two teams have ever met in the Atlantic Coast Conference tournament. Who would have thought? Here's a nice big three ball by Daniels.
Well, that's how Steve Donahue is. I'm sure he was really ready to go at Jordan Daniels at the end of the half, but gave him a nice pat on the butt after that shot, lifting his spirits up a little bit.
NC State takes a timeout with 15:32 to play.
Well, the BC cheerleaders have something to cheer about right now. Their team back within eight, and Lonnie Jackson has really kind of been a catalyst for them. Knocked down a couple of threes in the first half, and then some nice ball movement in the second half gets him very involved in the offense. And I'm sure that Steve Donahue says, let's take care of the basketball and not give away points.
He's another one of those BC freshmen who's been ACC Player of the Week. He had 26 against Bryant. We'll be back. The official ACC mobile apps presented by Havlin and Outback Steakhouse are available for your Android, iPhone, iPad, and Windows Phone from Nokia. Watch live ACC Network men's basketball games and daily video features. Visit the acc.com/apps to download today. Boston College just continues to hang around, Mike. The lead is eight.
Well, you can hang around by doing two things, shooting 5 of 7 or 71% in the second half, or not having turned the ball over once in the first 4.5 minutes. So they're doing those things much better.
Now they have to make some stops. But NC State has failed to put them away. Had them down 14-0 to start this game. This is Painter. His shot is short. They do make a stop. This is Clifford. Backs his way in. Finds Anderson. He scores, and he go to the line for one more. Ryan Anderson.
One of the things that Dennis Clifford is really good at, passing the ball out of the post. And nice look here, good flash, and then it's just NC State, the weak side defense, completely falling asleep on that play. You can't let a guy cut in front of your face like that.
Ryan Anderson was the LA Times Player of the Year out west. He's on the ACC All-Freshman team this year. Mike talks about his upside and the great future he could have in this league, and you see his numbers, 11 points, 5 of 8. And he misses the free throw. Six-point game. Wood looks inside. This is Williams.
Get it, go get it!
And another stop by Boston College.
Amazing to think that BC is in this position for a second time.
Anderson tries to bank it in, had a good look, had to go over the big fella. Wood for three. Yes.
Yeah, that's the thing. I mean, it's almost an unguardable shot, but he gets really good looks in transition.
He has 17 points. Has had a couple of really close buckets and can't finish. Back out front to Williams. Williams looks for help. Whistle and a foul away from the ball. That's on Humphrey, and that's his second.
You get the sense it's a dangerous game that NC State is playing, but you get the sense the players feel like they can turn it on at any time and stretch out this lead.
And they have.
And they have, but it's still, it's, you know, the longer this game goes, and as BC stays close within shouting distance, you're playing with fire.
Whistle and a foul away from the ball again. This is going to be on Lonnie Jackson, I believe. It is. That's two on Lonnie Jackson. He's trying to stay with Wood. Grab his jersey.
That's the one thing Mark Gottfried had said, that Scott Wood had gotten much better as the season went along about using screens and moving without the ball. And let's see, usually when somebody grabs you in that situation, you're doing a good job.
Here's Wood again. Didn't get a chance to square up, and Painter comes over the back and is called for the foul.
NC State foul.
Watch him, ISO him a little bit, and posting up, using a couple of screens. A lot of times for a right-handed shooter, you're getting better rhythm going the other way and swinging into your right hand. It's a little bit tougher to square up when you're coming around to your left.
Daniels with a good crossover move, but loses it on the way down.
The turnovers he had, where he's just, it has been defensive pressure, just mental lapses.
State had numbers, but they traveled with it. Turnover. So another opportunity for the Wolfpack gone awry.
You always run the risk if you give a big the ball too early on the break that something like that is going to happen, because a lot of times the referee, if it may not be a travel, but it looks like a travel when a big guy's handling the ball.
Under 13 minutes to play in the second game of the ACC tournament. Casey Cottle's giving him some good minutes today. Big body in there. Boston College trying to hang around. Nice pass. Boy, they had a chance at Anderson.
Yeah,
he knows he missed a great opportunity.
Yeah, and once again, you know, Heckman came in the first half and did a really nice job. It's 4.7 rebounds. And that's a good find. You've got to convert that. Of the freshmen that they have in, he played against the best competition growing up.
And there's a strong move. Anderson finishes, and he'll go to the line for one more.
With the free throw, a six-point game, maybe. Much better finish. I'm sure he had a lot more resolve to finish that play after missing that earlier layup.
Foul is on Howe, and that's his third personal. He goes out of the game, and Leslie comes back in. You know, I was talking to John Thompson III about why so many guys from California, Boston College is, I mean, John's recruited out there as well, and certainly Steve Donahue has done it. You see all the California guys. He said it's because of the school system out there. They're great students. They have the grades. They get into school. And so when they were with the Ivy Leagues, both John Thompson III and Steve, they recruited heavily out in California.
Well, and it's not just, I mean, up in Boston College. I think California is the fifth, by percentage, the fifth highest rate represented state in the university system, you know, the university-wide. So it's apparently a very popular school with everybody out in California.
Anderson misses.
Even Al Skinner used to go out there and get players from California as well. So it's not just Steve Donahue.
How about that pants and the catch and shot by Painter? Heckman looked at the three, wisely brought it back. Clifford.
Come on,
I'm not sure he meant to tap that in. I think the rebound surprised him. But still, they're hanging around, and this foul will be called on Matt Humphrey. But with 11:56 to play in the game, it's still 48-41 State. You are watching the ACC Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports. 59th annual ACC basketball tournament, the sixth time in Atlanta, the first here in Phillips Arena, and it's a 48-41 game. Fans need to see what's happening in the ACC. Haviland brings you highlights from every ACC basketball game. All you have to do is visit accdn.com or the official ACC mobile app for the latest highlights and all the video. During that timeout, Debbie was over by the NC State huddle. Let's go over to Debbie Antonelli.
Well, guys, the one thing Coach Gottfried said to his team is to trust the system. This is how we've gotten to this point, to play with a little more cadence on the offensive end. And C.J. Leslie needs to post up strong every time down the floor to help create some spacing. But Lorenzo Brown was the one that looked at his teammates and said, come on, y'all, let's go. We got to play smart.
All right, Debbie, NC State averages almost 74 points a game. They got only 48 here this afternoon with 11:40 left to play in this game. This is more like the second time they played, where NC State beat Boston College 56-51, low-scoring, sloppy game.
And nothing more maddening than coming out of a timeout and getting a quick turnover and the execution of that play. But you would think that there were some post-up mismatches for NC State, C.J. Leslie being one of them, Lorenzo Brown maybe being the other one.
Boston College scores here. Things will get a little antsy in here. Been a crazy crowd, but they turned the ball over. Back to Brown.
No spacing on that break at all. Couldn't get anything out of it.
Johnson looked at the three. Instead, he goes over to Wood. Back to Johnson, 20 on the shot clock. Here's Johnson. His shot is short. And a whistle and a foul against NC State. This will be against Painter. Let's take a look at our Hyundai trip around the Atlantic Coast Conference. The first game, Maryland won that easily, Mike, 82-60. One of the best games we've seen Maryland play all year.
Yeah, they're going to have to play that way offensively tomorrow against North Carolina to be in that game.
Then the night session, Virginia Tech and Clemson. Of course, Miami, everybody likes Miami coming into the tournament. We'll have to keep an eye on that game. They, too, trying to get into the NCAA tournament. Takes it in the paint. Wanted a foul, didn't get one. Now gets a shot block, takes it back again. And the follow by Clifford.
Unbelievable, could not get that to go down.
Wood for three. Yes! NC State continues to answer.
Can you tell me why somebody other than number 15 is shooting the ball right now for NC State?
I agree.
they kind of forgot about him here a little bit in the second half.
I don't know how you could forget about him. He was so efficient in the first half. 4-6, 3-5 beyond the arc. Perfect at the line.
There's the look, and you make Humphrey go right, and he's not quite as effective. But this one right there for Clifford, if you have to make that one go down, and then this is what happens as a result. So good in transition and running to the three line.
They call this foul against Scott Wood, and that'll be his third. So fouls starting to mount a little bit for the Wolfpack.
I'm going to take a possession or two from Lonnie Jackson. This is Wood is guarding. Maybe be aggressive, try to put the ball on the floor, see if you can get that fourth foul and get him over on the bench.
Okay, 10-14 to play, 10-point game. Daniels down the lane. And the follow is good. Here he is again, Ryan Anderson, having a terrific ball game.
Got really nice spacing that time. That opened up the drive and left him open on the glass.
But State comes right back and tries to score. They'll go to the line. Ryan Anderson with 15 points.
Boston College foul number 20, Lonnie Jackson.
Some of the scores from around the country.
15 fouls.
Well, how about the way Notre Dame turned their season around. Maryland beat them early and they weren't impressive. They really finished the season strong.
Yeah, Mike Bray has done a terrific job there. Strong tournament team.
Brown misses the first.
Syracuse got all it wanted from UConn in today, a 3-point win for them.
Meanwhile, Lorenzo Brown has another one coming. He's been right at the top of the ACC in steals, 74% free throw shooter. Nice season for Lorenzo. Makes the second. I think the summer league video of Brown blown by Chris Wilcox at the Chris Paul summer camp, it went viral when it hit YouTube.
You can't throw a lob to Connell in that situation.
Back to Brown. This is for two. Even close. Boy, Lonnie Jackson had a wide open shot.
And it's just a very casual turnover by Leslie that time.
Dennis Clifford comes back into the game for Boston College. And Eagles have a chance to cut into the lead again. Much motion right now for Boston College.
They're gonna grind down some clock too.
Daniels, nothing out there. Kicks it out to Jackson. And this should be Boston College basketball. It is. Good hustle play. You want to make sure you don't get hurt. Johnson went right over that table. He went through the photographers.
And you never want to save the ball underneath the other team's basket, but good hustle right there. You see, he stepped on the end line right there before he went out.
Man.
And you always want to try to dive into an area where your fans are so you know somebody will catch you.
you never want to go in with the media because they don't know how to catch you. 8:54 to play in the ball game. 30-second timeout. Reminder, coming up tonight, starting at 7 o'clock, more first-round action here at the 59th annual ACC tournament at the Phillips Arena. Andre Young and 7th seed Clemson take on one of the more dangerous 10th seeds you'll find in Virginia Tech with all-AC second-teamer Eric Green. Then, for more information on the tournament, just go to theacc.com. Interesting night. Virginia Tech and Clemson, Georgia Tech, and Miami. So a full night coming your way here at the 59th annual ACC tournament. I guess it's what you expect here in the first day. Crowd has been rather subdued, waiting for the excitement to build.
Yeah, but for NC State, I mean, they should be into this game and how critical it is for their season, their fortunes going forward. And I tell you, I didn't like playing noon games, Tim, and I didn't like playing that last one either. It never seemed like it ever got there, you know. And so that's really a concentration game for Miami tonight to be ready that late.
Not unusual in the first and second round games for the energy to be just a little bit lower than it is on Saturday and Sunday. No question about that.
For NC State, they just got to be shaking their heads saying, I can't believe we're in a 7-point game right now after this team didn't score for the first 7 minutes of the first half.
7 minutes and 23 seconds without a point. It was a 14-0 ball game, and Boston College gets it back. Daniels, dangerous pass taken away by Wood.
Horrible shoot the three.
Brown is fouled by Daniels. So, again, Daniels with a costly turnover as he did at the end of the first half.
Well, again, and Lorenzo Brown, he's so good in the open floor. And when he gets that deep, there's no way that Jordan Daniels can guard him. He's just too big. Daniels trying to pick up the cheap foul right there. Yeah, he knows those they've got to keep them out on the open floor, but NC State, 24 points in fast break situations.
Lorenzo Brown goes to the line. He's got 9 points here this afternoon. Averages 12. And the 6'5 sophomore from Roswell, Georgia, makes the free throw.
Two players on this state roster with Georgia ties. Richard Howell from Marietta.
Lead back up to 10. Ryan Anderson throws it away. It's almost like he thought Clifford was going to turn a different way. 18 turnovers for Boston College. We could be playing this one outdoors. It is really nice. We'll return after these messages from your local ACC station.
NC State up by 10, but Ryan Anderson having a terrific game, showing his ability to score inside. Got a nice mid-range game as well. Good movement without the basketball. Timmy's on his way to a double-double, 15 points, 9 rebounds. He's the only BC player who has a double-double this year. He's got 6 of them.
Every time they get close, they turn the ball over. They've been within 6 now, 2 different times, and turned it over.
Yeah, this is a critical 4-minute stretch right here for BC to show some resolve and hang in there. It looks like NC State ready to put this game away or try to.
The lead is 10. Inside they go. There's Howell by himself, and he's fouled. Foul will be on Dennis Clifford. That's 3 now on Dennis Clifford, the 7-footer from Bridgewater, Massachusetts.
Really nice looking. And again, that's what Lorenzo Brown at his size can do. He can make plays over the top out front. And if Howell had caught that cleanly, he would have been able to go up and score.
Richard Howell at the line shooting 2.
Howell makes the first one.
Really got a glimpse of how good he was going to be last year when Tracy Smith had some injury issues. He stepped in and played very, very well during that time.
6'8", 250-pounder from here in Atlanta. Got a lot of friends and family here at the tournament today. Howell actually started the season leaner, meaner than he had been. He was down 12 pounds at camp, now down about 15 from what he was a year ago.
Well, that was one of the first things Mark Godfrey did. He said, you know, we got to get in shape. That was order number one. They got to hit the weight room, get out on the track.
That was a nice pass there, but there's no shot. The foul will be against Richard Howell, and that's 4 on him now. So they'll have to get him out of the game, and Deshaun Painter comes back in.
There's one thing, if he has an Achilles heel, it is foul issues. He's got 5 DQs on the year. He's out there, he's got 9 points, 10 rebounds, so really solid numbers, but they need him on the floor.
Anderson is fouled, he'll go to the line to shoot 2. That's the last thing Mark Godfrey wants. He doesn't want to stop the clock and let him have points at the line.
Well, and the guy they need, we talked about Wood, but he's when he does something, it really wows you. But C.J. Leslie has been really quiet in the second half. They need him to reemerge.
Anderson is a 69% free throw shooter, but over the last 7 games, he's been much improved. Closed captioning for ACC basketball provided by Bojangles Famous Chicken and Biscuits. It's Bo time. Anderson has another one coming. He's now 30 of his last 45. He's got 17 points here today. ...56-47 with 7:10 to play. Well, the bucket will count. And Leslie will go to the line for 1 more.
Here's the look and trying to draw the foul. And again, he's such a tough matchup for Boston College with his combination of quickness and size.
I waited on that, Mike, to see if they called offensive. Instead, Leslie gets the bucket. He goes to the line and trying to get the 3-point play. C.J. Leslie has 8 points this afternoon. This is the free throw. Boston College is starting to run out of time now. They've got to protect the ball and score some points. Nice move by Ryan Anderson.
I really like his game. And, you know, you look to next year, maybe up that to 15, 16 points a game, 8 or 9 rebounds. That's a lot of productivity out of that position.
And they're going to call this on Dennis Clifford. Dennis Clifford thought it was going to be called offensive.
And that was a good It's getting chippy inside and very physical.
But you have to wonder how Clifford got called for that foul.
And they're going to take a look, I think, and see if this were, if there was an elbow thrown.
Again, the officials, Les Jones, Brian Dorsey, Sean Hall.
So with Bob not hitting at the line, 72%.
6:29 to play. Every time we say NC State's starting to pull away, though, it's a 7, 8, 9, 10-point game.
Yeah, and that's but that's just again the Boston College's ability to grab a hold of tempo and be deliberate down on the offensive end.
This is 1-1.
They missed a couple in the first half, and they've left some points on the table at the free throw line in this game.
So Painter makes the all-important first one. He's got another one coming. Just has 7 points here this afternoon. And he makes them both. So the lead is back to 11. Daniels from way outside.
Yeah, not a great shot. It was early in the clock. A long three.
But he's only a 30% shooter from beyond the arc. Leslie goes right around Ryan Anderson and slams it home.
And that's the type of move that the crowd needed to get reignited, and he just puts so much pressure on you when he squares up and has a live dribble.
That might be exclamation point. Here comes Wood. State's got numbers. Wood takes it himself. Boy, how sweet is that play, and how sweet of a player is he? Timeout, Boston College.
Ryan, you know, Mark Gottfried putting an arm around Calvin, as he calls him. But that is a lightning quick move and finish, and then down the other end and then getting out in the open floor. And these are the ones that have really hurt BC. This game, getting out in the open floor, at least it's a layup. But right now, if you're Mark Gottfried, he said, let's kick, let's go. Let's make this 25, not 15, and let's not sit back.
5:36 to play. Let's go over to Debbie.
Coach Godfrey talked to us yesterday at shoot-around about was dangling the carrot in front of his team in terms of postseason. It's been since 2006 that NC State was in the NCAA tournament, and he's got his guys believing that if they can play well and get to this level of play so they can get to the NCAA tournament, as Mike said, play their way off the bubble. You see they've got a couple of good wins against Miami, and their record is 20, looking to move to 21 wins, Mike.
Yeah, the one thing, though, that 0-6 against the top 50 RPI, and then they had their opportunities, and if they win this game, they'll have another one against Virginia tomorrow, which would be a huge win to pick up.
This foul, Mike, is against Scott Wood, and that'll be his third personal.
But the tournament looks at tournament wins as conference wins, so this would be the 10th conference win for them, if you will.
Lonnie Jackson at the line. 10-7
in the ACC against ACC competition. He's got 9 points now. Virginia Cavaliers staff sitting there looking on. They play the winner of this game, which looks like it'll be NC State.
Well, again, Virginia, it's going to be another team that controls tempo. And Virginia beat them at Raleigh 61-60 in their one game against one another. So it's going to be, again, a test of wills. And can NC State play at the pace they want to? But I'll tell you what, Tony Bennett has done a marvelous job there this year with some key injuries, and they've just kind of played through it.
Yeah, no question about it. Hassan Sen had recuperated. It's been 6 weeks since he had his knee, or has had his surgery anyway, on his foot, and he was ready to come back and then had some problems, broke a team rule, and he will not be back the rest of the season. Hassan Sen makes that Virginia team a little bit different team than they are normally.
Gives Mike Scott a little, somebody in the foxhole down low, but the Tony Bennett is not, he is, you know, you break a rule or you go outside of the team and you will not play. He has been very consistent with that in his tenure there.
Cal's shot is no good. And with 4.5 to play, NC State's taking this one over. Here's the run over the last 2.5 minutes. It's 10-4 run. Although NC State's had to work a little bit harder for this win than I think they thought they would when they were up 14-0.
Yeah, here's the look and a good two-man game. And that's what a great shooter can do. He just sees all eyes are on him, and it allows the screener, Painter, to get inside and get an easy layup.
Scott Wood goes out of the ball game. He's got 22 points.
Well, and I agree with you, Tim, but and NC State, 7 guys are going to play regardless. So, they're going to be out on the floor, but hopefully they can, for them, extend this lead and maybe get those guys just 2 or 3 minutes at the end of the game. And, it doesn't sound like much, but again, in tournament play, 3-4 minutes of rest is a big deal.
No, it's a good point. It's a huge deal. And as we said earlier, Mike, no team has ever played on Thursday and won the ACC tournament. You mentioned NC State had gotten to the championship game, but then had no legs when they got there. 3:38 to play. 66-51 NC State. And the Wolfpack trying to close them out down the stretch and move on to play Virginia tomorrow.
Let's revisit our AT&T fast analysis. And it's been rebounding. And I think NC State is... probably felt like they could have done a better job, but they did it well enough. Plus 4 rebounding total, Tim. 12 offensive rebounds for them. And as a result, only 6 second chance points. So just kind of prolonging the each possession.
Well, they started out so fast, Mike. Boston College scoreless over the first 7:23 of this ball game. NC State built that 14-0 lead. Here's a bank in that
Anderson
hits. What a game he's had today. He's got 22 points.
Validating that first team all freshman pick, was the leading freshman rebounder in the conference this year. And sometimes the backboard gets in the way to your advantage.
Johnson. That's for 3.
Alex Johnson.
So NC State continues to answer. Debbie, what do you have? Daniels, 3 ball.
Jordan Daniels for 3.
'69-57, NC State. Johnson for 3. Boston College got caught sleeping on that rebound. Hey, ACC fans, make sure you add the ACC Sports app on Facebook. It's the best way to watch the latest in the ACC tournament. Get all the analysis, highlights, breaking news, all while sharing with your friends. And, well, Mike says you don't taunt your rivals. Search ACC Sports in Facebook.
Not during the ACC tournament.
Oh, sportsmanship. Foul was on Lonnie Jackson. That was his 5th, so he now is disqualified. Leads with 10 points. And Dennis Clifford comes back into the game. C.J. Leslie at the line, 6'8", 209-pound sophomore from Holly Springs, North Carolina. All ACC. Pinches that one a little bit. Catches the front rim. Wood comes back in. Richard Howell comes back in. Williams and Painter go out.
I like Indiana in the NCAA tournament. It's good to see them back on the national picture. Cody Zeller, the brother of Tyler, having a great freshman year there.
I think Georgetown is going to be very tough in that NCAA tournament as well. Very athletic team.
You're such a Washington homer.
What are you talking about? Daniels looked at it, and they turn it over. Brown takes it right at the rack with an exclamation point.
For the way they started, you got to give BC a lot of credit for hanging in this game and right the ship and being competitive.
Under 2 minutes to play. Anderson with another rebound.
Wolfpack Nation gets to their feet. Well-deserved hand for their team.
Minute and a half to play.
Setting up a huge game tomorrow against the Cavaliers.
Mike Scott coming off that monster game against Maryland last Sunday. He had 33 points, 10 rebounds, double-double. Nice pass inside to Johnson, and he's fouled. And knocked to the ground. John Cowell will be called for the personal.
This is the steal right there. You talked about one of the leaders in the league, and then it's 6'5", everybody getting out of the way. I really like when they, he and Alex Johnson have a nice little rapport out on the floor together. It's a good combination for State.
Alex Johnson, only 5'9 and a half, 176 pounds. He's a graduate from Toronto, Ontario. Makes the first. Transfer from Cal State Bakersfield. Clifford goes out. Peter Rehnquist comes in, his grandfather, Supreme Court Justice Rehnquist. And it's good to see Peter Rehnquist getting some time here before they go home. He's a senior. This will be his last time at Boston College. Final 50 seconds. And NC State takes a timeout so they can make changes in the... Let's go over to Debbie. Debbie, what do you have?
Guys, one of the things we talked about was NC State's balance to start the game. It's not just what you teach. It's understanding the system. And this Wolfpack team certainly has bought into trusting the system. You see five players in double figures, or four players in double figures, Howell with nine, almost a double. But the other thing is NC State averages 60% of their baskets being assisted. They're right on that number right now in the basketball game.
Well, wholesale changes, Debbie. We've got Kendall Smith in the game now. Thomas Tate, Stats Battle comes in. Joaquin Raymond is in the game as well. All for NC State.
That balance scoring is going to be a key for them. And again, tomorrow, are they going to be able to play at the tempo they want?
No, you're right. I think that would be the key to the whole game. You're absolutely 100% right.
But it's clear that they trusted Mark Gottfried right from the start, and playing in his offense, the structure has worked, and understanding that everybody's involved and everybody gets touches. That's his first. And I tell you what, that's one of the keys to this season too, is sitting to his left and Bobby Lutz. What a great coaching mind. And I think he's those two together have been a terrific tandem. Rob Moxley next to Bobby Lutz as well.
Well, they've done a terrific job, haven't they, this year? I mean, when you look at the last year, the Wolfpack finished 10th. Here they are this year. They come in as the number five seed. It's a team that's looking at the NCAA tournament.
Well, in Orlando early, too, on that staff, just down the road from the bench. That's those four together, very much a team in their own right.
Banks it in. How about that by Joaquin Raymond? Daniels tries to answer it. Everybody getting playing time now. Smith right to the line. There's Dete. Final second. And NC State advances to play Virginia. The Wolfpack wins it 78-57 over Boston College. And the number five seed knocks out number 12. And now moves ahead to play four.
Right, and I think the key number in that game probably going to be 70. If it's under 70, it's going to be to Virginia's advantage. If they get it over 70, it'll be to North Carolina State's advantage.
ACC basketball has been brought to you by GEICO.
by AT&T, by Nissan, by BB&T, and by Food Lion.
Terrific game from NC State by Scott Wood. He had 14 in the first half. NC State ran out to the 14-0 lead, and they held that lead throughout most of the game. Wood ends with 22, and right now he's with Debbie.
All right, thanks a lot, guys. Scott, congratulations on the win. Another 20-point game for you, the third of the season. What was working for you on the offensive end?
I just think my teammates did a great job screening for me, and Lorenzo and Alex did a good job of finding me in a break. And anytime you knock down your first two and you kind of get in a rhythm, it feels good.
Scott, you told me yesterday that your system was built for a long run. What will it take for you to knock off Virginia?
We just got to come out here and execute. I think if we can execute our offense and guard our scout the way that we know we can guard them, we'll be a tough matchup for anyone.
All right, Scott, congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, back over to you, Mike.
All right, Debbie, thanks a lot. There's an NC State fan that, okay, game's over, let's go to sleep. We better get a little rest because we got a great night ahead tonight. We've got two games tonight, Virginia Tech, Clemson, Miami, and Georgia Tech. But right now, Debbie has got another interview, so let's go over to Debbie Antonelli.
All right, thanks a lot, Mike. Coach, about the 12-minute mark, I heard you tell your team to trust the system. What happened at that point? Because it was a single-digit game.
Well, I thought both offensively and defensively, we were getting away from what had helped us. We need to run our offense a little better, set a little better screens, wait for cut, you know, come off of a screen hard, good timing. We were getting away from that. We were trying to do a little bit too much on our own. And we just needed to trust what we were doing, trust what we've been doing all year. Made some shots in that stretch, and we had a couple defensive stops helped us as well.
Coach, what will it take for you to knock off Virginia?
Well, we've got to play extremely well. Well, we got a lot of respect for them. I think they're really good. The way they play makes it hard, too, because they're a little different than everybody. And, you know, they set great screens. They move off of screens well. The floor is spread. Their spacing is good. We've got to really be good and concentrate through possession, start to finish, and make sure we're really good at the end of the possession. Today we had to do that some. So that's good preparation for tomorrow.
All right. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, Mike, back over to you.
All right, Debbie and Corey, quick comment on tonight. Virginia Tech, Clemson, Miami, Georgia Tech. What do you think?
Well, we saw a lot of separation in the first two teams and first two games we had today. Not as much separation between Virginia Tech and Clemson, and then Miami getting started on their trek to what they feel they have opportunity to win an ACC tournament.
All right, well, it should be a great night tonight. And again, it starts at 7, Virginia Tech, Clemson, Miami, Georgia Tech, right here on the ACC Network. We hope you'll be with us. You've been watching exclusive coverage of ACC basketball on the ACC Network, an exclusive production of Raycom Sports. For now, so long from Phillips Arena in Atlanta, Georgia.